Thank you. So this is a work that has been done, let me go a little bit further, just to present the overall project that where we are working on. This is, I believe, one of the, if not the biggest, one of the biggest projects in Europe on organic food production. 5 year long project, about €6 million. And we are dealing a kind of organic approach to the project, meaning it is a holistic approach because we want to, we are dealing with the, let's say, Symbiobank, which is a bank of microorganisms that we are selecting for the use in organic crops. So we are dealing with development of technical means, that is what I'm going to talk today. We are dealing with the machine, new machines for product application, specifically for microorganism-based products, and there is a presentation on the other room. We are dealing with the orchard management and nursery management, and the quality of fruit, and also about the health of the people that are eating organic fruits. So there is a medicine, medical university which is involved, and they are testing on the people also how the eating organic fruits is about, let's say, what is happening, and of course. So when I was talking about evaluation of the products, we are dealing with the fertilizers and the plant protection products. So for the products, for the fertilizers, we are dealing on the effects on the plants, effects on the environment, and also to develop new products and carriers. Carriers is mainly for the microorganisms, because this is the major problem when you have a good organism that that is, let's say, efficient in the lab, then you go to the field and everything disappear because you don't have the way how to apply. We are dealing with three different plants, strawberries, apples, and sour cherry. But today I will talk about strawberries only. So for to evaluate what is the effect of the different products that we are applying, we wanted to have a little bit more deeper knowledge. So not just to see if 1 kilogram per hectare or 10 kilograms is okay, but I want to know how is acting the mechanism that the different products are, what are the mechanisms that are at the base of the action of the different products. Because for us it was important also to really define what are the doses, the best doses that we can apply. For this reason, we are dealing with the nitrogen metabolism, secondary metabolism also, and for different kinds let's say, analysis. I'm presenting you today about, let's say, the nitrogen metabolism, which is linked with the photosynthesis. So there is, we have different trials, but I'm talking to you today about only one, which is with the Santa. Santa is the cultivar that is most let's say, widely grown in Poland. And then we have, this is in the field, we have four plots, and each plot has 25 plants each. On the, and these are the products that we are applying. These are products that from, let's say, production point of view and also from an application point of view are completely different between them. Different also as concerned the let's say, the matrix that they are coming from, that they are produced from. So dry manure, that was for us the, they say, organic control. Then we have seaweed extract, vermicompost extract, and then this is vinassa, which is a product which is, let's say, just a byproduct of the production of yeast. So what remains of the broth, let's say, where the yeast is grown, the company was just throwing away. And then when I was talking with the guy and I was looking at the analysis of the product, I said, this is a beautiful fertilizer, so let's try it. And then we are trying also titanium, which is titanite, and the final one, which is a microbial inoculum. This is a product I've been working with, not this one, but similar. It's a company, since 20 years we are collaborating and developing also this consortium. So it is not only mycorrhizal fungi, but there are also some PGPR, so plant growth promoting rhizobacteria, and there is also so you have there the florescens and Bacillus subtilis and different species of glomus. I think this is important information, meaning that for us we had three controls, let's say. So the basic control is no treatment. Then we need to show that for the growers that organic can be comparable to conventional. So we have a conventional control, and then which is the NPK, and then we have the manure, which is the organic control, meaning this is the normal way the growers are using. And you see that zero is zero, but NPK, this is the normal, let's say, input that conventional are using, and NPK and manure is the normal amount of manure that they are using per hectare. All the others are half the amount of manure that we are using. Only one, it is humus up. We were following the producer suggestions. They said you don't need to give anything else, just give us what we tell you, and it's okay. And this is the amount that actually we are providing with the amount of compound that the producer is suggesting for to the growers, actually. So here you have two informations about the photosynthetic activity, and you see that these are products, this BF quality, Titanic and Vinassa. So BF quality is the seaweed extract, Titanic is the titanium, and Vinassa is this from the broth, let's say, of the yeast, were given on the leaves. So these are products that are sprayed, and all the other are given to the soil. And you see that there is a difference in the photosynthetic activity. But the difference is not due to something that is related with gas exchange, because you see here the stomatal conductance is the same among all the treatments. So it means that the water content and the say water relations and the gas relations between of the different treatments are similar. So there is something better, let's say, in the functioning of the mechanism of all the machinery, let's say, that is linked with the photosynthetic activity. And then we wanted to check also the fluorescence of chlorophyll A, which gives you, let's say, the generally speaking efficiency of the whole machinery, at least for photosystem one. And you see here that in young, these are the data for young young leaves and old leaves. So there are some differences here, let's say, so a little bit less efficiency in these two, manure and mycosat, but only on old leaves. I mean, young and old leaves were leaves in the same moment, only different age on the same plant. And then what was very interesting to me at the end, and because I would not expect such kind of results, was this. So you see here that, well, as expected, let's say, the NPK treatment had a much higher content of nitrate in the leaves. Definitely about, let's say, on average, if this is the average, it is 10 times higher. To me, was very interesting this, because humus up, if you remember, is the product with 0.1% of nitrogen. But when it comes to nitrite reductase, which is the enzyme which is actually making, let's say, is at the beginning of the whole nitrogen metabolic pathway, and you see that there are differences, but not so big differences, actually. This because the two have much higher, let's say, content of nitrate, have a little bit higher activity of the enzyme, and the other one are almost on the same. The titanate, which I would expect a little bit to give some, let's say, because titanium is included in the let's say, is one of the mineral elements that are providing some beneficial effects on photosynthesis, didn't give very much, let's say, is not acting on this part of the metabolism. But what was interesting, it was after, because the previous one was after 1 month of the treatment, when we go after 2 months, so when we do not expect any special, let's say, activity or effect of the different treatments, we still, and actually this is the case for all the treatments apart from the conventional one, we still have about 10 times higher content of nitrate in the leaves, but no differences in the activity of the enzyme that is, let's say, utilizing nitrate. So it means that there is an excess of nitrate in the leaves which is not used by the plant. So, generally speaking, I'm not presenting data about the production, because the production was also at the same level, more or less. So it means that the different products that we are using are acting even at a lower, if we let's say, provide half of the amount of nitrogen mainly, but also let's say very reduced amount of potassium and phosphorus to the plants, they are still utilizing. I mean, the efficiency of, in the use of these elements is much higher when we are giving them as organic. We think that that giving half of the amount of the mineral elements in the soil, which was actually given by the manure mainly, because all the other products were just increasing of 1%, let's say, the total amount of NPK that was provided to the plant. But nevertheless, this 1%, which is given mainly to the leaves for the three products that I was showing you, and for specifically for the mycosat. So this is the consortium which is made of mycorrhiza and PGPR. These are is enough to provide the plants of the amount that the plant needs in a period when there is the need of actually of the plant. This morning we were listening about the difference in end demand and end supply. And so we think that even though the different products are based on different mechanisms of action, they are, let's say, efficient enough to provide the plant a quantity of the different elements that are sufficient to for a good production. Thank you very much.
Here for some questions.
I was just curious if you have any data on your background soil fertility?
Yes. Of course, we use the same soil. That was a soil that, I mean, this is the second year of the after planting, because we had the soil that in the previous year was not cultivated. So we didn't do anything, and then we planted in 2010, and then we did already also all the treatments in 2010 and then in 2011. So the soil was, it's a kind of, this is a pozzolic soil, average fertility, let's say. Not a lot of organic matter in it. It is about 1%. If you want some more data about, let's say, microbiological activity, I have a poster in the other in the bar room, which is dealing also with the, let's say, analysis of fungi, bacteria, and nematodes in the soil. So we wanted also to see how these products are acting on the on that side. Moreno.
More or less, well, the same question. If you check the nitrate in the soil, you take nitrogen. And that if this can explain the huge amount of nitrate that you found in the leaves.
Yeah. It is a soil which is, I would say, even there is not much organic matter, it is a fertile soil anyway. This is a soil which is which has been growing fruits for decades, okay? And it has been, we think, over fertilized. Because it is an experimental station, so they are always trying to. It was never used for experimental purposes, I mean, for fertilization trials. So they were always using the same standard, which is the standard that we have been also using in our experiments. But for I mean, 1 year for the strawberries was enough, let's say, because this is the second year of the trial. Was enough, let's say, to see the decrease in the amount of nitrogen in the soil, because we found only huge amount where we continue to put this inorganic compound, I mean fertilizer.
Thank you.
Thank you.